Hello guys, today I'm going to discuss how you can use your old modem as a Wi-Fi access point, repeater and network extender. The main reason I bought this second-hand router is to help my Raspberry Pi 4 projects. It needed an Ethernet common access point to share a single mouse and keyboard with my Windows PC. Obviously, that is totally a different topic of discussion, and I will discuss it in next video. Now let's discuss how you can use an old Ethernet router as an additional network access point plus network extender and repeater. I got a Sky broadband contract. The router provided by Sky has got only two Ethernet ports. The Wi-Fi signal is really poor and it barely reaches to my workroom, only one floor up. Besides, my HP Z420 workstation does not have any Wi-Fi card. Initially, I used TP-Link Wi-Fi Powerline Extender Kit to connect my workstation with the router downstairs. It communicates through the AC main power line. Now, I will connect this second-hand router to my TP-Link Powerline Wi-Fi Extender socket. The final network diagram will look like this and more like this. Now, with the default settings, any router will have same IP address, which is the default gateway IP address of 192.168.0.1. Any router will have DHCP on. With the DHCP, the router have the power of assigning IP address to the connected device. We want this power to be retained only for the main router, not the additional router. For this reason, we have to customize the additional router in two things. The first thing, we will assign a new IP address, anything other than 192.168.0.1. I think just to keep it simple, we will assign it the new IP address of 192.168.0.253, and we'll turn off the DHCP setting. In this way, the router will work as a relay device. First, I will press the reset button to customize the additional router. You need to hold the reset button for 30 seconds till the light flashes. Then you restart the router and connect your any device, either the laptop or desktop or mobile phone. I connected my mobile phone with the additional router Wi-Fi. In the browser, I type 192.168.0.1 and login. To login the modem, you need a username and password. So the username for my modem is admin and the password is sky, SKY. For your modem, for different brand, just simply search Google. You will see all the detail. Now, as you logged in your router, the settings may not exactly look like same, but you always look for local area network, LAN IP setup. In my case, I found the LAN IP setup in advanced tab. So this is advanced tab and this is the LAN IP setup. Use router as DHCP server. So uncheck the DHCP server. So the router cannot assign any IP address to any of the devices, and change the default IP address. I change it to 192.168.0.253. Now I turn off this router and after 30 seconds power it on. Connect it to the TP-Link Ethernet cable. It is all ready to go. I can connect my Raspberry Pi 4 with the Ethernet port, and same time I can connect my workstation to the same router again with the Ethernet port. I use new router, Wi-Fi signal with my cell phone and other peripheral devices. So the router has done its job. It can be used as an extra network access port. It can be used as a Wi-Fi repeater and extender. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you at next time. Thank you.